Thank you. Thank you. You're probably wondering what all of this is going to do. Actually, you watched the whole video and you got to this point. At least I hope you got to this point. And I was running out of time, so I finished the back of these. I made two of these. I only actually need one, and you'll see what it's going to do in a second. But I finished this off camera, which is just facing it off and cutting this bevel and drilling it and tapping a 1/4-20 hole in there. And you'll see why in just a second. But let me move the camera over here, and I'm going to show you what the reasoning for all this is here, if I can. It was kind of hard to explain in just a little comment on Instagram, but this hole, I started this hole in this part, but I started it before I had milled this pocket in here, and I milled a counter bore, and then I went in here with the drill, and I don't know if you can see it, but there's... because the bottom of the counter bore intersected this hole that goes down the length of the part, it was only actually cutting on the top of the drill, so it's tending to force the drill downward like that in the, if you can imagine that, because it's only pushing on the top, forcing it down. And it didn't do it enough to mess the part up, but there's a little bit of a step here. And then when I went in with the gun drill to finish the hole, because I got to go down and meet this 1¼-inch hole coming up this way in the part, this is what the end of the gun drill looked like after it went in there, because it broke the tip off of it. So I have to figure out a different way to do this, because that's not working. Because see, what happens is this drill is at a very steep angle like this going in here, and I have to have the spindle of the machine back. See if I can get this camera back a little bit more so I can explain this. The spindle of the machine is wide, and so it's up here, and this tool's coming in, so you gotta have a tool like this long just to meet the part without hitting the side of the spindle on the part here. If you look at the up there, the spindle, how wide it is here, you'd be hitting the corner of the spindle on the part. So I have to use such a long tool, and you get a lot of deflection, and this is becoming a problem with this. So what I was doing, here's what's going to be the little drill guide, and it's going to go in here like this, and I'm going to put a hole through here that, you know, matches the drill diameter, and it's going to help the drill start. And I have done this before with a gun drill, and it's worked okay, when as long as the gun drill has like a bushing, a pilot bushing, which is what this is going to in effect be. So the actual assembly, you remember we made these clamps, and we made this top piece. So this was a clamp here, and it's going to screw together like this and clamp around the part. Because you can't of course have this moving around in here, so it has to be held in here securely, and that's what this is going to be doing right here. And what I just got to make sure that it's up against the front here. There's actually an angle on the back of that. You saw me machine it. And this sticks out about 10,000ths further than when this mates up against the radius of the part. So when I tighten this down, it'll really be pushing it hard down against the bottom of that pocket. So that's what you saw me making in this video here. So this is the bottom clamping piece. And the next video we're going to be working on, actually drilling this hole in here and making the pilot for the drill at the appropriate angle. See, it's going to meet that. Right now this is perpendicular to where the hole's going to meet it, right here. And so that's going to be the next video. But this is just the fixture, if you will, to hold the bushing. That's going to be that little part that fits in the milled pocket. So I'm going to mill the pocket first, and then I'm going to drill the hole. And that way I can just use one tool, a gun drill, just come in here, straight in here, and drill through into the 1¼-inch hole that comes down the part up to about this deep here. Kind of a lot of work just for one drill guide, but this is the best way to do it. Otherwise I got to use too many tools, and they're real long tools, and I'm going to have a lot of deflection here on the tools, because they're so long. They're almost like 12 inches long coming up here, and then a little bit longer even to get down in there. So if you made it this far in the video, now you can understand what all this is about. So thanks for watching, and look for the next video. I'm going to be finishing this thing up and finishing the hole.